Hey yo, what's going on guys? Welcome to a new video, and today we're going to be talking about the Sonic movie and how it might impact the next Sonic game. If you like the video, make sure to like, comment, favorite, subscribe. Anyway, Sonic's 30th anniversary is coming up very soon, which means that we're probably going to be getting game announcements. And if we're getting game announcements, that usually means that we're going to find out something new about the next Sonic game. Which begs the question, how much of an impact did the Sonic movie have on the game? We all know about how the Sonic movie was a massive success and pretty much printed money. Massive success like that is bound to have some effects on the other properties of Sonic. And the only reason why I'm covering this is because of a collab with a mobile game that is featuring Sonic the Hedgehog. I don't know anything about this mobile game and I'm probably not going to pick it up, but if you're interested, I left an article from TalesChannel down below, so make sure to go check that out. Anyways, the important detail shown in this collab is the fact that Sonic has lightning surrounding him. This was a character trait that was blatantly taken from the Sonic movie. And to be quite honest, I don't really hate the electricity. I actually kinda like it. And seeing from fans' reception, it looks like it's all positive here. This shows that the movie has 100% had some impact on the games. How much of an impact on the games is still up in the air, which is exactly why I'm making this video today. I wanted to talk about how much of an impact this movie will have on the games and what I think could go wrong and what I think could go right. I'm going to be going over some good and bad things that could come from this situation. Just know that this is all speculation and nothing that I'm saying is fact. So something that I want to discuss that is bound to be brought up eventually is if movie Sonic will replace modern Sonic. Now, if anyone is worrying about this, don't worry, I don't think they're going to do it. From this collaboration, it looks like this is what modern Sonic is going to look like from now on. He still looks the same, except now he has electricity around him. But, if they ever were to slap movie Sonic as the main Sonic in the games, I think that might be the straw that breaks the camel's back. I think I'm actually done with Sonic if that happens. Call it petty, but if movie Sonic is the main character, I'm moving on. But something that is kinda interesting is that they might make a movie Sonic skin for the Sonic games. Kinda like an unlockable so that you can change modern Sonic into movie Sonic. But the main reason why I want this to happen is because if it does, this could open the gates for other skins to come to Sonic. Like, say you're playing a boosting level, instead of Sonic, you put on the Blaze skin, so now you're playing as Blaze in the boosting levels, or maybe you want to switch to Shadow. I think there's some potential there, and yes, you can already do that with mods on PC. There is a lot of console players that I kinda want them to experience what we experience. But honestly, this would be a dream come true because I love the idea of cosmetics in Sonic games. So yeah, Sega, if you want to add movie Sonic as a skin over modern Sonic, go right ahead, but why not give us other skins while you're at it? Okay, so the next thing that I want to point out, and I swear if this becomes true, oh man, I think the electricity looks great, right? But I do not want it to replace Super Sonic. As of recent, they have been avoiding the Chaos Emeralds ever since Sonic Generations. Sure, it's in Lost World, but that's side content. And when it comes to Sonic Forces, there wasn't even a Super Sonic. There was a DLC one that you pretty much had to download, but there wasn't a vanilla Super Sonic that comes with the game. There was none of that. And I'm hoping this is not true, but it kinda looks like Sonic Team doesn't want to use the Chaos Emeralds. And spoilers for the Sonic movie, Sonic doesn't go Super Sonic. He just gets this electricity around him when he's upset. And I hope that this isn't the replacement for Super Sonic. And you guys may be saying like, oh Matt, you're just kind of over-exaggerating. This is way too far-fetched. Look around you! Sonic Team is neglecting the Chaos Emeralds in the mainline games. They weren't in Forces, they were side content in Lost World. This is not far-fetched. Sonic Team is known for doing dumb stuff like this in the past. I'm sorry if I seem like I have trust issues. It's because I do. Okay, I'm done with that rant, but the point is across. I really do not want this in the next Sonic game. Okay, so our next point is the personality of Sonic. Anyways, there's going to be some spoilers for the Sonic movie here, so just bear with me. As you guys know, Sonic's personality was pretty different in the movie. He was a lot more insecure and was kinda like a sad hedgehog. In the game, Sonic is very brave and confident, and he's overall a great role model. Okay, but hear me out. I love the Sonic movie. I think it was a great movie, it's an awesome interpretation of Sonic, but I do not think that we should be mixing movie Sonic with modern Sonic. The Sonic movies don't need to be anything like the games, and the games doesn't need to be anything like the movies. These are two interpretations of Sonic, and they should be completely separate. While it's fine for movie Sonic to be sad and insecure, I do not want that for the games, because the game Sonic already has an established personality. Putting movie Sonic's personality into the games is just going to mess things up, and I really do not want that to happen. And again, I love both of these interpretations, but they should be kept separate because it's what makes them unique and memorable. So yeah, Sonic Team, do not bring in the movie Sonic personality into the games. I would hate that, and trust me, the fans will hate it too. Well, I mean, I don't know if the general audience would be mad, but trust me, Twitter will hate you. For our next point, we have a positive-ish thing to look forward to, and that is the rings opening up worlds. Sega has been using this artwork for Sonic that has been teasing the 30th anniversary where Sonic is just holding a ring. And there has been some theories that this is a reference to the movie, and it shows that in the next game we might be able to enter other worlds. Well, after this collaboration, it is clear that they are adding stuff from the movie into the games. So, how far-fetched is it that we might get some portal rings? Again, I'm not saying the portal rings are confirmed. This is all speculation. I think there is a huge possibility that these rings are going to be used to enter other worlds, which shows how much the movie has impacted the games, in a positive way. If we just get the rings and the electricity, I would say that's a positive impact. I just hope we don't get any of the other stuff. Anyways, if this does happen, I would love it to death, because that means we're going to be exploring different dimensions for Sonic. And if we're exploring dimensions with Sonic, that could mean that there is a link between the Sonic games and Sonic Prime. Guys, I'm just realizing how awesome this theory sounds, and I'm hoping it comes true. Anyways, the dimensions idea is a really great idea. We get a change in environment for Sonic, and it's just really interesting. But concluding today's video, I believe that the two interpretations of Sonic are both awesome and they deserve to be separated. I don't think the electricity is a big deal, but I hope it doesn't affect more than that. Anyways guys, that's the end of the video. If you like the video, make sure to leave a like, because it helps the channel out and I'd really appreciate it. So yeah, make sure to like, comment, favorite, and subscribe. But before we move on, we have to cover giveaways. Right now, if you join the Discord server down below, we are planning on doing 3 Discord Nitro Classic giveaways, so if you're interested in that, make sure to join. One of the giveaways is going to be completely random, and the other giveaway is going to be a quiz on how much you know of Sonic. The person who scores the most points will get the Discord Nitro Classic. And the last giveaway is a secret. You have to be active on the server to find out what it is. And while we're talking about the Discord server, I might as well promote it. Make sure to join the Discord server down below. We are a very supportive community when it comes to art, so if you make art, make sure to join. We love seeing what you guys create. And if you don't make art, we are still a really active community that you can talk to about what your favorite Sonic games are. We're not very hostile, so you won't get attacked for your opinion. Lastly, the VCs tend to be active and I join in there sometimes, so if you want to talk to me or some other awesome people, make sure to join. Anyways, we are moving on to our channel members. I'm sorry to keep you guys waiting, I just need to get that out of the way. For our channel members, we have Thomas1Rye, StixDaBadger, ShadowPoser, Sonopedia, TheSqueakerNerd, SuperShaddixBoom, Snix, Sonic Extreme, Super Saiyan Sonic, Just Kidding and Kidding, Scape, SonicPip, and SonicFan. You guys are awesome! Thank you guys so much for helping out the channel. You guys help out in so many ways and it helps. It just helps a lot. I can't stop saying helps. Thank you guys so much for going out your way to help me. You guys are cool. And anybody else who's cool, make sure to follow my Twitter. Over there you can talk to me or see my current opinions about the franchise. Anyways, I love you guys. Yakuza 0 is awesome. Adios.